Sesame Street Show 125 in color.
Seen him. Well, look right over here. This is Grover.
Hey, Susan!
See, I told you you know who Grover was. Boy, when you see him in the neighborhood, I think we better tell Kermit to keep his eyes open.
Greetings! Kermit the Frog here, and today I am here to talk to you about this letter right here. And,
Hey, Froggy!
Oh, no.
How are you, Frog?
I'm fine.
Oh, good.
Now, listen, Grover.
Mm-hmm?
I want you to be quiet, because I am talking about this letter right over here.
Oh, okay, I'll be quiet.
Okay.
I, Grover, will walk on tippy toes. Shh.
Okay. Now then!
Sorry.
Now then, please look at this letter right here, okay?
Squeaky shoes. Sorry.
Yeah. Okay, who can tell me what this letter is?
That's a G! That's a G! The letter G for Grover. First letter in my name, Grover. Just
right.
down there, see? Big G, Grover!
All right!
Okay. Sorry.
Now then, that is the capital letter G.
Mm.
Okay?
Yeah.
Now then, everybody, look over here at this letter here. Okay. Now, who knows? Who knows what this letter is? Well?
Well, what?
Aren't you going to break in and interrupt and yell what letter that is?
No.
Why not?
Because Froggy.
Yeah?
Froggy, I do not know what that letter is. Oh, I do not know.
Okay. Well, take it easy.
I do not know.
Okay. Take it easy.
Okay, right.
Okay, because I'm going to tell you something.
What?
Okay, this letter over here is the letter G, right?
Yeah. G for Grover.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, this little fella here is also a letter G.
It is?
Mm-hmm.
Do you mean this little fellow here is also the letter G?
Yep.
It does not look like the letter G.
Well, you see, it's a small G.
Oh.
You see, this one over here is a capital G.
This is a small G.
And this one here is a small G.
That is a capital G.
See, they're both the letter G.
Oh, G for Grover!
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
Okay, well, now you've
got
it.
Wait.
What?
That's not right. That's a little G.
That's a little G.
Grover should start with a big G, a capital G. That's it. There See, you go. That's it. Right.
That's the capital G.
I like the... Wait. No. I want the capital G. I want the capital G. No, that's it. That's the Grover that I know. See, the capital G starts Grover. Mm-hmm. Oh, no. No. Come back, capital G. Oh, I love you, capital G. I love my G. I'm going to take my G home.
Oh, now, wait a second.
Oh, G, I love my G.
You can't take the letter. I mean...
Bye, Froggy!
Well, anyhow, he was right. The capital G is for Grover, and the small g here is for, can be for goodbye.
G. Gorilla. Gorilla. Gee.
Ta-da! Friends, today we're going to play a game.
I win. Give me the prize. I win.
The game hasn't started yet. Now, friends, on this curtain is the...
I know. It's a letter.
Right. And do you know what this letter is?
What?
It's the letter G. And behind the curtain is something that begins with the letter G.
Oh, it's a gate. The gate begins with the letter G. Gate. Hear it? Gate. Oh, well, then, of course, it's a goat. It's a goat. Gum. Gum begins with the letter G. It's a piece of gum.
The thing that was behind the curtain is a gorilla. Shh.
Now? A goldfish. That's it, a little bitty goldfish.
Grunt.
Oh, it's a grunt. It's a gurgle. It's a giggle.
No, I am sorry.
Could it be a goose?
This thing that begins with the letter G is a gorilla.
Gorilla. Of course. Gorilla. A loose gorilla. A wild gorilla. A wild loose gorilla. A wild woolly gorilla. I can't find a door. Which way is it? Loose gorilla. Come with me. Get the gorilla. Let's go. That gorilla.
Hello there. I am a goat. Goat begins with the letter G.
Uh-oh.
This is the letter G. G has a ga sound, as in gopher or gorilla. I wanted to show you something that begins with the letter G, but I couldn't find a single thing. Wait! There is something. Right here. Grass.
The story of the boy and the girl and the jelly beans. Chapter 1.
Oh boy, am I happy. I mean, I just feel fine. I'm feeling so groovy. And I'm feeling happy because I have my little bag of jelly beans here. And jelly beans are the greatest. Because I just love jelly beans. And whenever I have me a few jelly beans, I just feel groovy. Well, hello there, little girl. How are you?
How am I?
Yes, how are you?
I'm sad. That's how I am. Oh. I'm miserable. That's how I am. Oh. I'm crying. That's how sad I am.
I guess you are sad. Hey, well, listen, I'm feeling groovy. Maybe I can help you. What's wrong?
I lost my jelly beans.
Well, you lost your jelly beans. Well, that's not so bad. I mean, it's nothing to cry about.
Nothing to cry about.
No, there's nothing to cry about.
Nothing to cry about? Mm. Jelly beans are the greatest. Jelly beans are the best.
That's true.
Did you ever lose your jelly beans?
Well, no, but...
Well, then you don't know how I feel. The only way you could know how sane I am is if you had some jelly beans and you lost them, too.
Well, listen. Listen, I've got some jelly beans.
You don't?
Yes. And you know what?
What?
I'm feeling so happy and so good that I'm going to give you my jelly beans.
You are?
Yeah, sure. Here.
Oh, that's fantastic. My jelly beans! Oh, thank you! Oh, I feel great! I feel groovy! Oh, I'll have my jelly beans! Oh, jelly beans! Oh, bye-bye!
There. I cheered her up. I gave her my jelly beans and I cheered her up. I gave her my jelly beans. I gave her my jelly beans! I gave them away! And jelly beans are the greatest! And now I don't have any! I've lost my jelly beans. Oh, no. Oh, how sad I am. Oh, how unhappy I am. Because nobody could know how unhappy I am unless they'd lost their jelly beans. Oh, dear.
Will our hero ever get his jelly beans back?
I doubt it.
Stay tuned. In a few minutes, we'll be back with part two of our story.
Do you know what that gibbon likes to eat?
No.
Well, look at him. There he goes again.
He's eating jelly beans?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, man.
He's eating jelly beans.
Isn't that amazing?
He goes like that. Do you know what kind of an ape this is?
Yeah.
What he's called? What's he called, Patrick? Do you know?
Yes.
What? Starts with G. It's it. He's a gibbon.
Because
he starts
with G.
He starts with G, so he's a gibbon. Look at him eat that jelly bean. Can you say gibbon?
Yes.
Let me hear you say gibbon.
Gibbon.
You know, they really know how to swing through trees. See those long legs
hands.
They have? Yeah, long hands. They can swing faster than almost any other ape or monkey through the trees. You know what's really fun? When the babies are very, very small, they hold on to the mother's or the father's waist. They hold on very tight right around their waist, and they swing right through the trees, holding on to their mother's and father's waist.
She's so cute.
Wouldn't you like to do that? So would I.
I like his eyes.
Mm.
They're so bright.
Mm-hmm. I don't know what he's thinking. I think he thinks, I like orange jelly beans, but best of all.
That's like.
Yeah, he's chewing like that.
Oh, look, he's gonna
see.
Swim.
He's gonna stand up. He's coming over to say hello.
Oh, he's looking to see if he can find any more jelly beans.
Say yeah. Say hello, Mr. Gibbon.
They love
the...
up there.
Yeah.
He likes to swim.
See how he can walk right on his hind feet like that.
Yeah, well, she's all the toenails.
Long arms like that? Well, that's our old gibbon and...
He has four legs.
And four legs, right. Well, I don't know.
I think he's holding on to the floor.
Well, all I can say is that I've never seen anybody like jelly beans better than that.
Oh, listen, I know somebody who really likes jelly beans.
Really?
A matter of fact, I think it's time for chapter two of The Boy, the Girl, and the Jelly Beans.
Ah.
And now, the story of the boy and the girl and the jelly beans. Chapter two.
Yep-a-doop-a-doo-doo, scoop-a-doo-bum-a-doo. Well, I lost my jelly beans, but that is okay, because I'm not sad anymore. There is no reason to be sad, because I am cool. I am confident. Nothing can bother me, because I am cool.
Oh, you scared me. and I am afraid. Oh,
yes?
I am so scared. I am so frightened.
Yes?
Oh, I am afraid. Oh.
Well, listen there, girl with the jelly beans. How are you?
Oh, Emma.
Yes.
Oh, can't you see I'm afraid? That's how I am. I'm scared. Can't you see me shaking?
Yes. Well, listen. Listen, I am not afraid. I am confident. I am cool. Perhaps I can help you. What is wrong?
What's wrong?
Yes.
A great big monster was bothering me. That's what's wrong.
A great big monster?
Yes.
Well, hey, listen, that's okay. That's okay, because I am not afraid of monsters.
Did you ever have a great big monster bothering you?
Well, no, but...
Well, then you don't know how I feel. The only way you can know how I feel is if you'd ever had a great big monster bothering you.
Well, listen, if he comes around, see, I'll try to help you out.
Oh, thanks. That's very nice of you. Oh, that's so nice of you.
Yes?
And I, for that, am going to give you your jelly beans back.
Oh, gee.
There.
Well, that's very nice of you, little girl with the jelly beans. Thank
gee,
you.
I feel much better now.
Oh.
I'm not afraid at all.
Well,
I feel confident now.
Mm-hmm.
Like there's nothing to worry about.
Well, that's good. Because there is nothing to worry about. I mean, be just like me. Because I am never afraid. You know, I don't have a care or a worry in the world. And I'm afraid that I'm afraid. I'm afraid that I'm scared. I'm afraid that I'm so scared that I'm shaking.
I'm not afraid at all.
Oh, you're not?
No, I'm not. Do you want to know why?
Yes, why? Why?
Well, because that monster right behind you, by the way.
Yes?
He wanted my jelly beans. That's why he was bothering me.
No.
But I don't have the jelly beans anymore.
No,
so
I do.
So there's nothing to be afraid of. Goodbye.
That girl is, she's too much, isn't she? listen, you want some jelly beans?
Yum, yum.
Have some.
Yum, yum, yum.
Help yourself there, you know, just enjoy them, you know. They're good for you.
Yum. Thank you.
He ate them all. Well, I'm not afraid anymore.
So, our hero is no longer afraid, but he still doesn't have any jelly beans. Stay tuned. In a few moments, we'll be back with the final part of our story.
You know what that is? That's a five. Now, five is more than one, or two, or three, or four. And you know what I've got five of? I'll tell you.
Oh, I've got five people in my family, and there's not one of them I'd swap. There is a sister and two brothers, and a mother and a pop. That's me. Oh, five is such a pretty number. I'm awfully glad that I've five people in my family.
One, two, three, four, five.
One,
two,
three, four,
five.
Oh, I've got five people in my family.
That's true.
And there's not one of them that I'd ever swap.
Oh, no.
There is a sister.
And two brothers.
And a mother.
And a pop.
That's him.
Five is such a pretty number. I'm awfully glad that I'm five people in my family. One, two, three, four, five.
One,
two,
three,
four.
One, two, three, four, five.
Today we're going to talk about the number five. And you know what the number five looks like?
I can count up.
Can you count up to five?
Want me to?
Yeah.
One, two, three, four, five.
Wow, how about that?
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
Five.
Hey, let's show everybody what five fingers look like. Let me see you count five of your fingers. Do you have five fingers here?
What?
Do you have five fingers?
One, two, three, four.
Wait a minute. Hold it. Go back. I think you skipped something. Do that again.
You're gonna tear my blouse.
Oh, well, I'm sorry. I was just taking it down and getting it out of the way.
One, two, three, four.
Wait a minute. No. Go back. Do that again. I think we missed something.
One, two, three, four, five.
Yeah, that's five fingers.
The story of the boy and the girl and the jelly beans, chapter three.
Boy, am I mad. I am really angry. I mean, I've lost my jelly beans twice in one day. You know, if you lose your jelly beans once, it makes you sad. But if you lose your jelly beans twice, it really makes you mad. And all I have left is my little jelly bean bag with no jelly beans in it, and I am really mad.
Why am I mad? I am so angry I can scream. I'm in a rotten mood. I am mad.
Oh, hello there, little girl. How are you?
I am mad.
So am I. I bet I'm madder than you are.
Ha! You don't know what mad is until you're as mad as I am right now.
Oh, yeah? Well, what are you mad about?
I found my jelly beans. Hmm? Yeah, I thought I lost them, but I left them right here, and I found them.
That's why you're mad? Huh. Boy, that's nothing to be mad about.
That's not why I'm mad. I'm mad because... Now, listen to this.
Okay.
I am mad because I found my jelly beans and I don't have anything to put them in, so I can't take them home and I can't eat them because it's dinner time soon, so I'll just have to stand here forever looking at them because I don't have a jelly bean bag to put them in, and that's why I'm mad.
Well, let me tell you that is nothing. Now, I'll tell you what I'm mad about. Now, see, I have my little jelly bean bag here, and it's empty, because I've lost my jelly beans twice today, and I'll never find them because a monster ate them, and all I have left is an empty jelly bean bag, and that's why I'm mad.
That is nothing to be... You have a jelly bean bag?
Oh, yes, I do. What difference does... You have jelly beans.
Uh-huh. I do.
Well, I have a bag to put them in.
I'm not mad anymore.
I'm not either.
Would you like to come to my house for dinner?
What'll we have for dessert?
Jelly beans.
Oh, good.
Let's put them in the bag.
Okay, fine. I'm so happy.
And so... with Jelly Beans for All, the story of the boy and the girl and the jelly beans ends happily.
The Zipper. The
Greetings. It's me again, Kermit the Frog. And over here I have my nifty jelly bean collection. Now, today I'm going to try to show you guys what people mean when they say the word most. Okay, got that? Most, right? Now, as you can see, it's really quite simple. Like, well, for instance, this jar right here has some jelly beans in it. See? Look at the jelly beans, and you can see that there are some jelly beans. Got that? Let's go to jar number two. Jar number two. You can see by looking in jar number two that there are more jelly beans in jar number two. Got that? There's some jelly beans here. There are more jelly beans in here. Let us now go to jar number three. Jar number three. Look at jar number three. Wowee! Look at all them jelly beans. You can tell that this jelly bean jar here has the most jelly beans of all in it. Look at that jar. Most of all. Now, let us review. We have some jelly beans here. We have more jelly beans here. And we have most jelly beans here. Got that? Once more. Everybody ready? We will... What?
Ooh.
What are you... Hey, listen.
Jelly beans.
Oh, yeah, oh. You got the...
Bango.
Hey. This jelly bean jar is empty. But we can still do it here. Yes, I think so. Because this jar here has some jelly beans in it still. And this jar here now has the most jelly beans in it. You see? There are some jelly beans here, but this jar here has the...
Oh, more jelly beans! Bango.
Okay, let's see. Okay. We can still do it, by golly. We can still do it. We have two empty jelly bean jars here, but we can still do it because we can still use the word most. Because now this jar here has the most jelly beans in it. See? Two empty jars, but this jar here now has the most jelly beans.
Jelly beans!
Listen. Wait a minute.
What?
Stay right there.
Where?
You too. I'll be right back.
What?
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Greetings. It is me once again, Kermit the Frog. Pay attention. Come on now. Now, once again, I'm going to try to explain the word most. Now, this time, I have here my marble collection. Got that? At ease. My marble collection. Okay. Now, over here in this jar here, we have some marbles. Okay? Some marbles. Right? In the second jar, we have more marbles.
More marbles.
And in the last jar over here, in that last jar there,
most.
We have most. That's right. Most. There you are. And there we have a most unhappy monster.
Met 26 letters for the alphabet. You got to learn them before you can read, write, or spell. You might become a teacher, we can never, never tell. Learn such words, yes sir, I hear so much for that. They go like this, come on now.
A-B-C-D-E-F-G-H-I-J-K-L-M-N-O-P.
get in doubt, don't pout, you better watch out. Learn your ABCs a little better. You got to know every letter.
A, B, C, D, yeah. E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, and then O, P.
We have a very interesting picture here, and it's kind of special. We'll discover why it's special in a minute. What's that a picture of?
Train.
Okay, is that the modern kind of train that you would see today?
No.
No, it's an old-fashioned steam locomotive. And this is just the locomotive part and the coal car. So, what makes it so special?
They're all shapes.
Yes, it's made up of a lot of shapes. What shape do you want to take off first? Let's just take off each shape at one at a time, each category. What shape should we take off first?
Circles.
Let's take off the circles. Okay, Mary, help me. As we take off the circles, you tell me what they are. Come on, Mary, you can help me. What are these circles?
Wheels.
These are the wheels, okay? This great big wheel is the driver wheel. We'll just take these wheels off. You see any more circles?
Yep. The smoke.
Oh, all the smokers' circles. Look at that. The whole smoke rings. Okay, you see any more circles?
Yeah,
yeah, they're kind of hidden down here, but see, they're full circles. You know what those were?
No.
That was the boiler and the whistle. Okay, now, what other shapes do you see?
Triangle.
Oh, let's take off the triangles. You know what that is? That's the light. That's a triangle. Take it off. That was the light. And what's that triangle under it? The cow catcher. You know, cows used to get on the train tracks and they'd have to push them off. Here's a triangle that's kind of hidden under there. What was that?
Where the smoke comes out.
The smokestack, right. Now, what shape was that you were just touching?
Rectangle.
Rectangles. Let's take off all the rectangles. That was part of the smokestack. That's the whole big engine. That's a little coupling between the engine and the coal car. And this is the coal car back here with no wheels. Oh, what's that shape that's left there?
Square.
That's a square, and that was the cab. Oh, what happened when we took off all the circles, the triangles, the rectangles, and the squares? What happened?
It's gone.
We don't have a picture anymore. Well, we took our whole picture away, but now here's somebody who will make shapes back into pictures for you again.
Triangle, square tree, pine tree, Christmas tree.
To make up, I think. Oh, I know what it's gonna make. I think. Ah, that doesn't look right.
Whatever it is,
square inside a square. I know, he's gonna do something else. Triangle, square, triangle.
You know what it's gonna be, don't you?
Squares.
Looks funny.
Rectangle.
Rectangle.
Oh, this is simple.
Simple.
A boat.
A boat.
Yeah.
What?
It's a sailboat, I think.
Not a sailboat? Well, could be.
Not very interesting.
Yeah. What?
Want to make other things.
It could be a pinwheel.
I know.
A flower.
Yeah.
A flower. A
a pretty, beauty flower.
Yeah.
Pretty flower.
Hiya. My name is Kermit, and today I'm here to talk to you about this new, super up-to-date, latest model rectangle. Now, this rectangle, as you can see, is a very special shape. Now, the rectangle has four sides. Let us count them. Four sides. The top, that's one side. The bottom here, that's two. This side over here, that's three sides. And way over here, that's four. Okay, see, four sides. Now, you will also notice that the rectangle has four corners, and each of these corners is the same. In other words, each of those corners goes zzz, zzz, just like that, you see? Now, remember, friends, the rectangle with four sides and four corners, all the same, and it's got two eyes and... Two eyes?
Hi.
Excuse me, fellow, but would you mind sort of bugging out of here? Because I'm trying to explain about the rectangle, and if you could just leave so I could do my explanation about the rectangle.
Sure, buddy.
All right, fine. Now, as I was about to say, the rectangle here has four sides, one of which is broken. It's also got another broken... Listen, why don't you just leave and go find yourself a circle or a square or something like that, huh?
Okay, bye-bye. Yeah.
What you see here used to be a rectangle.
And it still is.
Hmm?
It's a rect, and it's a tangle.
Ten, nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one.
Not much happening today, is there, Bert?
No, not much.
It's kind of dull.
Yeah, sure is.
I'm bored, Bert.
Yeah, me too. You know, I sort of feel like reading the newspaper, though.
Hey, Bert, that's a swell idea.
Yeah?
Hey, listen, why don't you run down to Mr. Hooper's store and buy a newspaper?
Oh, no.
Why not?
No, I went to Mr. Hooper's store yesterday to get the newspaper, remember?
True.
Yeah, and I got the newspaper the day before, too.
Yes, you did.
And the day before that.
Oh, I believe you're right there, Bert.
Yeah, so, Ernie, it's your turn to go down to Mr. Hooper's store and get the newspaper.
Yeah, okay. You went the last few times, so it's certainly my turn to go get the newspaper.
It's only fair.
Yeah, I'll go just as soon as I put on my scarf.
Okay. Hey, Ernie. Hey, you don't need a scarf on a day like today. It's warm and sunny out.
Well, it's warm and sunny right now, Bert, but you never can tell when a sudden cold spell might set in, you know?
Okay, anything you say, Ernie.
Hey, where's the umbrella, Bert?
Umbrella?
Mm-hmm.
Ernie, there isn't a cloud in the sky.
Well, but if a sudden storm came up, you know, I might get wet and catch cold.
Oh, boy. Okay, I think the umbrella's in the closet there, Ernie.
Okay, thank you, old buddy, Bert.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. Here it is.
Hey, Ernie, come on now. Cut that
these
out.
These come in handy, too.
Hey, you don't need... Hey. What is that?
Alrighty.
You don't need an umbrella. And let's put this stuff back here, okay?
Okay, no. Mm-hmm.
Now, that is silly.
Huh.
It is a beautiful, sunny day out, and you're going only half a block.
Oh, hey, you're right, Bert. I'm going to need these. My sunglasses.
Now, why will you need those?
Well, you just said, Bert. Yeah, beautiful, sunny day out.
Yeah?
Yeah. Oh, which reminds me.
What?
Oh, my suntan lotion. Gotta get my suntan lotion.
Suntan lotion? Ernie, I want my newspaper.
You know how easily I sunburn, Bert.
Oh, sure. Oh,
just
boy.
Just put on a little lotion here.
Come on, you finished?
Yep. Did you want some suntan lotion?
No, I didn't want any.
Okay. Oh, flashlight. Flashlight. Gotta get a flashlight.
Flashlight? Oh, yeah. Ernie, it's morning.
Yes, but, well, you never can tell when it might get dark, you know. I can shine a flashlight around. See where I'm going.
All right. You got your flashlight. Now, are you ready to get the newspaper?
I certainly am.
Okay.
As soon as I find the bubble gum.
Bubble gum?
Mm-hmm.
What for?
Well, in case I meet any bears on the way.
Ernie, there are no bears on Sesame Street.
Well, you never know, Bert. You know, better safe than sorry, I always say.
All right. So maybe you'll meet a bear on the way to get a newspaper. Now, what good will the bubble gum do?
Well, you see, you give the bear a piece of bubble gum.
Yeah?
And he's so busy chewing that he can't bite you.
That is the dumbest thing I have ever heard. Besides, we don't have any bubble gum, Ernie.
Oh, no.
Why?
Oh, that's a shame.
Why?
Without any bubble gum, I just guess I can't go get the newspaper then, Bert.
Okay, Ernie. You win. I'll get you some bubble gum, okay?
Oh, thank you,
Bert. I'll be right back.
Hey, listen, Bert. Where are you going to get the bubble gum?
I don't know. I suppose Mr. Hooper's store, I guess.
Hey, well, listen, while you're there, pick up a newspaper, would you?
Hiya, Jim.
Oh, hello, buddy.
What you doing?
I'm just reading the newspaper. You know, it's a little dark in here. Would you put the light on, please?
Sure.
Yeah. Hey, Jim. I think the bulb blew out.
I know the bulb blew out. I can see that. Well, don't just stand there. Get a new bulb. What are you doing with a light bulb in your pocket?
If you put it in your shoes, they break. Hey, Jim. You want me to put the light bulb in for you?
Oh, no, you'll just mess it up. I'll do it myself.
I'd probably mess it up.
You'd
you can
probably
do it.
Mess it up. Uh-oh. This is too high. I can't reach it.
What are we going to do?
You see that big box over there? You bring that big box over here. See? I'll stand on top of the box, then I'll be able to reach the light.
That's good, Jim. I put the big box over here under the light, and you're going to stand on top of it, then you can reach it.
And I'll be able to reach the light.
Uh-oh. Something's wrong here.
Wow. That's high, Jim. You know, if you can't reach it, it's high. I never saw anything you couldn't reach.
I got it. Do you see that other box over there?
Yeah.
Bring that box over here. Put that box on top of this box. I'll stand on two boxes. Then I'll be able to reach the light.
That's smart, Jim.
Yeah.
Because if I bring that box over here and put it on top of the big box, and then Jim stands on top of both boxes, boy, you can reach that light bulb,
sure, aren't
you? Go get him, Jim.
Okay. Bring the box over here.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, Jim. Little box on top of the big box, and then Jim
gonna stand on both the boxes.
Two boxes,
and then it'd be so easy to reach.
Go get him, Jim.
Wow, boy, that's higher than I thought it
was.
That's
a high light bulb.
I don't understand it. I bought the big box over here. Put the other box on top of the big box.
Hey, Jim. Do you know why you can't reach that light bulb?
Why?
The tops of your boxes are broken.
No, they're not broken.
Jim, they're broken. Get off and I'll show you. The tops of your boxes are broken. Look at here, Jim. Look. See? The tops of the boxes are gone.
What do you call that?
That. The top of the box.
Does that look broken to you?
No, that's not broken, Jim.
Well, then what are you bothering me for? I have to unscrew out this old bulb. I have to get a real good grip on it. Okay? Now, buddy, you pick me up and turn me around.
Oh, okay, Jim.
Okay?
Yep.
You ready?
Yep.
Go. All right, turn me around.
Okay.
Okay, the bulb's out.
The bulb's out?
Now, wow. Take the old one out, and we'll put in a new one.
That's real good, Jim.
And when I get it into place, you pick me up and turn me around.
Okay.
Go. No, the other way.
Oh, okay,
Jim. Gotta screw it in.
How you doing, Jim?
All right, one more time.
One more?
There, we got it.
Hey, come
on. Now, we got a new bulb.
Well, that's a new light bulb.
That sure is. I told you I'd fix it.
Jim?
What?
You know something?
What?
I think you could do most anything you want to do.
You know something?
Yeah.
I think you're right. Okay. Now, I'm gonna go back to reading my newspaper.
Yeah?
I want you to put the light on.
You're gonna read the paper.
Sure.
And old Buddy's gonna put the light on for Jimmy.
Right.
Hey, Jim. I think the light bulb blew out.
I know the light bulb blew out. I can see that. But don't just stand there. Get a new bulb. What are you doing with a light bulb in your pocket?
If you put them in your shoes, they break. Hey, Jim. Want me to change the light bulb for you?
No, you probably mess it up. I'll just do it myself.
I'd mess it up, but you can do it, Jim.
I can do it.
You can do most anything you want.
What do you think I have here today?
A kangaroo.
A kangaroo, right. We just hopped down to say hello to Oscar. Oscar was amazed that we had a kangaroo here today. Say hello to Charlie, Norma. Want to pet him a little bit? Kind of soft and furry, isn't he?
Mm-hmm, yes.
Hey, tell me everything you know about kangaroos. Patrick, what do you know about a kangaroo? Hmm? Huh? They have four legs? That's right. Hey, you know what's kind of different about kangaroo legs? I've got to keep this little rope around his neck or he's going to jump right off out in the street there and he might get hurt. You know what's sort of different about kangaroo legs? Norma, tell me.
I don't know.
Well, look at them. The front ones are sort of short, aren't they?
Mm-hmm.
And the back legs are much longer, right? You know why that is? Do you know why kangaroos have big, long hind legs? Patrick, do you know? Why?
He has five legs.
No, he doesn't have five legs. He has four legs, but the hind legs are much longer because that helps him to jump.
That's why he roller skates.
That's why he roller skates? He looks like he roller skates. They come from Australia. Whoa, he's a jumping kangaroo.
Now this part of Sesame Street is brought to you by fathers. Now there are a few things you need to be a father. See, I'm a father. Now first of all, you need to have a wife, and I've got one, and here she is. You also need some children. I've got a couple of those. This is my son and my daughter. They're brother and sister. But since this part of Sesame Street is brought to you by fathers, I'd like to tell you a little bit about what fathers do.
A father can fix anything, leaky tap or broken spring. In his home, a father's king,
and that's what fathers do.
Bless you.
Tell him, Pop.
Right. A father buys you food and clothes, takes you to the movie shows, works all day to give you those.
And that's what fathers do.
My daddy.
Right. A father is a person with a very busy life.
He takes care of his children.
And he takes care of his wife.
He'll teach his children right from wrong, so they'll grow up safe and strong. Now this father sung his song, and he has told to you just what fathers do.
Hello, young fella. Glad to meet you. How'd you like to buy a Z? Very useful for talking and writing. Allow me to demonstrate words that begin with Z. You start with zipper. Zither. Zebra. And zany. All right, my man, how about it? This beautiful Z at a great saving. Saving! You get it? possibly you still don't realize Z's uses. For instance, zip and zigzag. How about that, huh? Ready to put a little zing in your life? I'll give you one last demonstration. Zombie and zoo. Now, what will you offer for this Z?
Zero.
Oh.
I'd like you to know that this part of Sesame Street is being brought to you by mothers. To be a mother, you need to have a husband.
And that's me.
Yes, I have one right over here.
Oh.
And you need some children. And they're right there.
Hi.
My
Hi.
Son and daughter.
Hi, Mommy.
And their father.
Hi,
that's us.
That's us.
But
yes.
Since yeah. this part of Sesame Street is being brought to you by mothers, I'd like to tell you a little about mothers.
Oh, Mommy.
A mother cooks, a mother sews, a mother washes all the clothes, helps to wipe a runny nose,
and that's what mothers do.
Mother bakes an apple pie, hangs the laundry out to dry, sings her kids a lullaby.
Oh, that's what mothers do. Gosh, Mom.
A mother tucks you in at night, as comfy as can be.
And if you trip and fall, she'll put a band-aid on your knee.
A mother cares for everyone,
husband,
daughter, and her son.
And now this mother's song is done, and now I've told to you just what mothers do.
Of course, not all mothers' work just stops there. You know, lots of mothers have jobs outside the home, sort of like I do. Some don't, but some do. But I'll tell you one thing that all mothers have in common. Can you guess? Of course, children.
Children.
That's right. This part of Sesame Street is being brought to you by kids.
By little girls, by daughters, by sisters.
By boys, uh-huh. by brothers, by sons.
See, children are really great. And I'm a daughter, which means I have a mother and a father who are right over there somewhere. There they are. Yeah. And I'm also a sister, which means I've got a brother who is right here.
And I've got a mother and a father, too. They're the same as her mother and father.
Uh-huh.
She's their daughter, and I'm their son. And she's my sister. And since this part of Sesame Street is being brought to you by her and me, maybe we should tell you a little bit about ourselves. Now you sing it. Come on.
A daughter plays with dolls, you know, helps her mother cook and sew, and in her hair she wears a bow.
And that's what daughters do.
You sing now.
Okay. A son can run and throw a ball, jump up high and never fall, grow up to be 6 feet tall. That's what a son can do. You sing it.
Okay. A daughter can be beautiful when she puts on a dress.
A son can make a mud pie and get covered with a mess.
Uh-oh. But still I like my brother fine.
And I'm glad my sister's mine. We're together all the time. And now we've told to you just what brothers do.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20.
Hey, Bert. Bert, come in here. Come on in here, Bert.
Yeah.
Hey, Bert. Yeah, I got a quiz for you.
What do you want now?
I got a quiz for you, Bert.
Oh, boy. Not another game.
Yes, yes. This is a quiz, and it's called What Happened Here? See? Now, what's going to happen is I'm going to show you a picture, and you have to tell me what happened just before I drew it, right?
Yeah, okay.
Okay, ready?
Except these games are always so simple, you know, Ernie.
Not this one.
All right.
Take a look at this.
Yeah.
Now, here's a picture of a bird cage.
Yeah.
And the door on the bird cage is open.
Yeah.
Now, what has just happened?
Well, what happened is the door opened, and the bird flew out.
Well, that's right. Hmm. Well, let's
was that one of your hard ones?
Well, we'll get another one.
I hope so.
Okay. Here's a picture of a man. That's a man. And down here is a banana peel.
Yeah.
Now, what has just happened?
Well, the man just stepped on the banana peel and fell down.
Yeah, so, well, that's right, too. I bet you peeked at these, Bert.
No, I didn't. They're all so simple, Ernie. Mm-hmm. I told you that
here's
before.
Here's a tough one. Here's a tough one, Bert. Let's see if you can tell me what happened here.
What happened there?
Mm-hmm.
Ernie, I don't see anything.
Well, will you give up?
No, give up. That's ridiculous. The paper's absolutely blank.
This is a picture of a cow eating grass.
I don't see any grass.
Of course not. The cow ate it.
I don't see any cow.
Well, after she ate the grass, she went
she
home.
She went home.
Why should she stay around?
Sure.
Hey, you know how fast this kangaroo could jump, or some kangaroos can go?
No, how fast can he go?
Oh, hi there.
What's his name?
It's Charlie, and he can go about 25 miles an hour.
Hi, Charlie.
Say hello to Charlie.
Hi.
As a matter of fact, you better say goodbye to Charlie, because I think he's about to leave.
He's running away. Goodbye, Charlie. Goodbye, everybody. Hey, Charlie!
Come on back, Charlie. Come on, Charlie.
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters G, Z, and by the number 5. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.
This is NET, the Public Television Network.